Implementing a countdown to track the seconds spent playing this game is easy. We can just use a regular interval. The question is, do we need to put this information on the state or not? And to answer that, we need to answer another question, which is, do we need to display anything in the UI while the timer is ticking? We should probably do that. We should probably display this remaining seconds, like you start with 10 seconds and then the counter ticks that down every second, and we should display the number of remaining seconds in the UI, which means we need to put this number on the state of the game. Let's do that. We'll start with remaining seconds. I think that's a good name. And we start with 10. Of course, we can make this configurable if we need to, if you want to make the game harder. Just like random number count, we can make this game receive another property, and maybe a good name for this property would be something like initial seconds. This is a number, and it's required. And in here, instead of hard coding this, we use this.props.initialSeconds, and we can pass the initial seconds down from the app component in here. So initial seconds are 10. Okay, great. So now we have initial seconds. What we need to do is, when the component mounts, that's where we're supposed to start intervals. We can't start the intervals before the component mounts because the user can only interact with the component when it's completely mounted. So let's do component did mount, and inside component did mount, we'll define this interval. We can use sit interval, and we'll do a function. We'll do that function every second. Inside that function, we want to basically decrement the remaining seconds. So we'll set state inside this function, and we'll return remaining seconds, the previous state remaining seconds minus 1. And we can display the remaining seconds somewhere here. For testing, I'm just going to replace this game status test with the remaining seconds. So this.state.remainingSeconds. Of course, this will work. However, it has a big problem. So I do have remaining seconds and they're ticking, but I did not stop this timer anywhere. So this timer is going to continue to go down into the minus. So let's go ahead and stop this timer. The best way to stop this timer is to actually clear it using clear interval, which means we need to capture the ID that this set interval method gives us. We can place this ID on the component instance itself. So this dot, call it interval ID. And the reason I placed it on the component instance is we need to also clear this timer when the component unmount. So on component will unmount, I also need to clear this timer. I'm not supposed to leave timers behind. So we'll do clear interval here using this dot set interval ID. And we'll do the exact same condition right here after we set the state. So the best place for this new condition is inside the second argument callback for set state, because this callback will be invoked after the set state operation. And in here, we can place a condition that says, if this dot state dot remaining seconds is exactly 0, I need to stop the timer, which is the exact same statement that we use in component will mount. Again, the reason we're placing this here in the second callback of set state is because set state is asynchronous, and I want to do this statement exactly after the set state operation is performed. Testing that now, the timer starts from 10 and it continues ticking all the way to 0. And when it hits 0, it should be stopped. This seems to be working. So now, when that timer hits 0, if I am still playing, the game should automatically be over, which means our game status computation has to be a little bit different. There is a condition that is superior to all the other conditions. Basically, if this dot state dot remaining seconds is 0, I need to return lost. This condition happens before all the other conditions. Let's test that. So the game status is playing because I'm not seeing any colors. And when the remaining seconds hit 0, the game will be over automatically. While this code seems to be working okay, we actually have many problems. One problem that you probably identified already. I also need to clear the timer when I win or lose the game manually. So let's say I won the game, right? I need to stop the timer because otherwise it will go down to zero and it will make me lose the game after winning the game. So that's an edge case that we need to handle. But the other bigger problem is now this line, because this line is going to be computed every second. And the truth is, I don't really need to compute it every second. I need to compute the game status on every click or when the remaining seconds hits zero. So there are fewer conditions to compute the game status. So that's something we could optimize, because the computation of game status involves actually computing the sum of an array. Now, it's probably not really a big deal for this particular case, but I'd like to show you how to optimize such cases. If you want to optimize the rendering of the game status only when needed, how would you do that? And the answer is, you would cache this game status computation and invalidate that cache when needed. Let's do that in the next video.